Now we're playing with power. NFL Network's Dan Hansis will join us in a minute. So let's run through his week four power rankings up now on NFL.com. The Eagles are on the NFL tomorrow night, so let's do an Eagle theme here. This is the Sam Eagle division. He's a grumpy Muppet with the Dolphins down at 32. The Jets plummeting down to 31. Get healthy, Sam Darnold, please. Some people think Joe Flacco looks like Sam Eagle. I don't see it. Next, the American Eagle division. Kay, help me out here. This is a wooden roller coaster in Gurnee, Illinois.
Yes.
Six Flags Great America.
Super scary.
The American Eagle.
The Demon.
Oh, my. Never. The Demon. That'll be next week.
Batman?
Eagles at 17 with a big game tomorrow night. Tampa Bay Buccaneers rounding out at 24. Batman was awesome because there was Prince while you waited in line. Next, the Eagles. Yes, the Eagles, the rock band. Peter, are you angry they only got two? You like Witchy Woman?
I love Witchy Woman. I love New Kid in Town.
All right, well, Dan loves the Vikings, and he loves the Saints. They round out the top 10. Baltimore Ravens just on the outside looking in. And then lastly, the top eight, the Iron Eagle division.
Hey.
We represent Iron Eagle. Peter worked with them, and the Patriots are working everybody. Number one heading into the big showdown against the undefeated Bills. Look at the Buffalo Bills at number six. How cool is that, Western New York? But let's bring in the man responsible, the man behind the power from Los Angeles. We call him Danny Hansis.
Hey,
good morning, Danny.
I love it. It's good to hear it. How is everybody?
All right, so listen, another Danny just took the league by storm. Danny Dimes, Peter's calling him Danny Crypto, and no team has moved up more of the rankings than Danny Dimes Giants, so you are in on Dimes as a player, as a nickname, as they host Washington this week. Am I right in saying that?
You're right. I love everything about Danny Dimes, and it is this whole saga is, should be a learning lesson for the Twitter mob who wrote this kid off before he ever threw a pass just because they were angry with the GM and the Giants not doing what they were supposed to do. Well, guess what? You got to see him on Sunday, and this kid could play. We were talking about it on the Around the NFL podcast yesterday in terms of kind of debuts that really changed the temperature in the room. You have to go back to maybe RG3 in 2012 for a young kid that had a lot of hype and then completely blew up in a perfect way in his first start. I love the way the Giants have some energy around them now, and it's going to be tough without Saquon Barkley there for Danny Dimes. But you know what? You got the Redskins up next. I believe they're going to be moving up the power rankings again this time next week.
You're right. I think back to Deshaun Watson on that Thursday night game against the Bengals,
oh,
right?
Yeah.
That big run. We're like, okay, he's going to be great. That's how you feel with Daniel Jones. Let's stay with the NFC East. The Eagles are in your top five after week one, and now they're not there. What do we make of the Eagles, and what do they need to do on Thursday night football in Green Bay to get back up in those rankings?
Peter, I still love the Eagles, but I had to send them to power rankings purgatory this week just because they were so annoying to me the last 2 weeks, especially the wide receivers.
Oh.
And it's nothing personal to these backups, but they're just not playing at the level you need them to play at right now. J.J. Arcega-Whiteside has a killer drop that probably cost them the game on Sunday. The Sunday night before, of course, it was Nelson Aguilar dropping the pass, which led to the guy outside the fire catching the babies, making that great bit. What they need is some wide receivers to get back in action, catch the ball after 7-plus drops on Sunday. Alshon Jeffrey returning on Thursday, which it sounds like it's trending that way, is a really good step in the right direction.
Dan, one of the main reasons that they dropped was because of my former team beating the Eagles on Sunday. But here's the thing. My Lions, they sit at 2-0-1, but that's not good enough for you. You have them at 14. What do they need to do to crack the top 10? Or do I need to call somebody from Detroit to come see you and put hands on Hansis?
Okay.
Oh, no. Hands on Hansis. I don't like that. You know, I was on your wonderful show last week, and I caught a lot of fire for not having the Lions in the top 10. And I couldn't bring myself to do it because I still see this as like an 8-8 team masquerading as an early contender. I think they've caught the Chargers last week and a bad week in a game they probably would have lost 9 out of 10 times, and that's not a fair thing to say, but I can say it. It's my power rankings. And then this past week, the Eagles, talk about catching a team at the right time. They also got the Eagles when they were beat up with injuries on both sides of the ball. There's something to be said for being able to close out games, which the Lions did. So I'm going to keep them at 14 where I have them now. Show me something against the Chiefs. I mean, that's going to be an almost impossible ask. But if you hang tough against the Chiefs, you could potentially move up in my power rankings exercise, even if you lose. All this undefeated talk. Come on, you tied the Cardinals. What do you want from me?
Danny Hansis, you're the best. But I think Nate knows. He knows. It sounds like you're getting a lot of venom from people on Twitter, Dan. I want to talk about the best matchup of the week. I think it is in Buffalo. I think it is the undefeated Patriots visiting the undefeated Bills. Will Sunday serve as an indicator of how good this Bills team is, and how far are you already willing to move them up?
I mean, how could it not? And maybe I got a little overexcited moving the Bills all the way up to number six. But it's an exciting time. And, you know, Dawson Knox on the angry runs, I think that was a perfect pick for this week because that was the type of play that electrifies the fan base. And if this is the year the Bills kind of make that step and start to become a real power player in the AFC East, people always remember that play. So I was thinking about this. What was the last Bills game in that building at New Era Stadium that really got people excited? And my research tells me it might have been Saturday, December 28th, 1996, wild card playoffs, Bills-Jags, Marv Levy versus Tom Coughlin. It's been a long time since there was a game nationally that people were excited about, can't wait to tune into. And, yes, with this defense, which we've known is good for a year, we've known it's good for a year, and Josh Allen, the gains that he's making, I like their chances to play a really tight ball game and maybe even win.
They've been the number one total defense the Buffalo Bills have since the beginning of 2018 through these first 3 weeks of the season. They can certainly get it done, and Bills Mafia is here for it. Thank you.